Hey, what's going on, world? Good morning, and I am excited to tell you that today is a little bit different than usual. I get to work out with a great friend and mentor of mine. A big shout out to you, Lance. Thank you for coming and supporting me and helping me get to that level of physical fitness where I'm trying to get to. Because boy, I do not know what I'm doing. I am thankful for the people in my life like Lance, and I'm also thankful for YouTube, because here on YouTube there are so many people that are giving away tons and tons and tons of free advice on how to get in shape, how to lift properly, how to adjust your form. I've never lifted a weight in my life. The most I've ever lifted was a double cheeseburger. So it's gonna be really great. Now I get to actually come to his gym, so this is exciting because I am now at 24-hour fitness. So this is my first time being at this gym. So since starting to work out, I've always gone to the Keller Point, which is a local gym in my city. I get to come and check out where he gets to work out, how he does it, how he moves, and how he's gonna suggest changes and updates for me so I can get the best performance. So I'm really motivated, I'm really excited about today. It's gonna be an awesome workout, it's gonna be a great day, and I'm just very thankful for people that sow into other people's lives, which hopefully this is a help to somebody. What is that point where one is just interested in getting into shape, whereas one does not have any other choice but getting into shape? And for me, that was when I met with this pastor friend of mine. His name is Mondo Davis, just an awesome guy. And he spoke life into me, and he looked at the strengths that I had, and he gave me some excellent, poignant advice of creating a schedule and keeping to it. And he took time out of his day. He's like the executive pastor, second, like the number two in charge of the church that he is pastoring at. And Pastor Mondo, he spoke into my life, and he essentially looked at my skill set and said, you know what, you need to have a schedule. You're very detailed oriented, and if you have a regiment to follow and you can stick to it and you don't look to your schedule as optional, not in an inflexible way, but in a way where you mold your life around this schedule and you leave occasional time room for buffer, but 90% of the time, that's what you follow. Those few instances where things crop up and rise to the top, that's where you want to have a little bit of movement so you can accommodate, you know, for friends and family, obviously, etc., etc. So Pastor Mondo spoke to me. He told me, this is how you're going to be successful in life. And I was so changed by that. That's where God started doing a huge movement in my life. He put me in connection with this guy I'm going to work out with this morning, my friend Lance, and Lance just spoke into me. Basically, he gave me this program and said, you know what, I was overweight, I had lost 30 pounds or so, getting down to a good healthy weight, and all it is just, it's so simplistic. That's why people have a hard time buying it. It's like, well, it's got to be complicated. And sometimes in life, we just need to learn how to receive. We just need to learn how to receive a free gift, a gift that doesn't necessarily cost anything. It's costing your time, it's costing your exercise, but monetarily speaking, it really doesn't cost anything to count your calories, eat less than what you're supposed to consume, barely. I mean, not crazy, 80% is what I'm thinking. 80 to 90% less than what your max is. And then counting your macros, which are your carbs, your proteins, and your fats. So making sure that you're not going over too much in one category. You want to keep in line, but eating up into those levels. It made so much sense to me. It felt sustainable. And that's what I needed. I needed someone to give me a plan that can help me sustain eating well over a long period of time. Not a fad diet, not something that's I'm just going to start and then immediately stop once I hit my goal weight. I need something that I can keep going for the rest of my life, and that's what I believe I have found. I'm excited about it. I know how to gain weight, but I definitely also know how to lose weight, and I want to learn how to maintain that weight off. And I believe through healthy exercise, lots of it, and eating well, you can do this. But where is that flash point in your life? What is it going to take for you to get fed up with yourself, fed up with living the same way that you've been living all this time and all your life, and get to a point where you're ready to overcome and become that conqueror, to become the best you that you can be? I know my kids are in school right now. I'm focusing in on them. I'm honing in on my marriage, and I'm just trying to get through this season of my life. But I don't want to put everything else on pause. I don't have a window where I can actually go back to school. I'd love to do that one day. That's something that's also on my agenda. But for now, I want to get in better shape. I want to take care of the temple that God has given me and make it the best temple that it can be, so I can be the better witness for Him.
Boot.
As you can tell from that last set of footage, I did a workout in the gym. I had my friend there, Lance, helping me out. Go Lance, thank you. First time doing some squats in a real way. I feel like I learned a lot from Lance today. He really helped break down the proper form, the proper grips. It was great. It was great learning, and did my first deadlift today. It was real exciting. So a lot of firsts today. First time at 24-hour fitness lifting, and first time working out with Lance, first time new workouts. So just a real exciting day. This is really encouraging to me, and I'm looking forward to the gains that will, the fruit of what will happen because of what happened today. I know going forward that there's just more growth and more gains to come. So I'm looking forward to sharing those with you. Thank you for being on board with me during this transformation of going from flabby to not too shabby, and I'm just real excited that we get to share this experience together. I'd like to introduce you to probably my best friend. I call him, he's very much a kindred spirit to me, Evan Agee. He has a YouTube channel as well. Please take a look at his YouTube channel. You can find it, his link down in the description below. I'll also paste it here at the bottom of this screen. Evan, I'd like to just ask you a couple quick questions about yourself. And sure. Number one, what did it take to you to get to the point in your life where you decided to make this transformation and this change? What drove you to that point in your life?
Well, like most people, I got to this point several times. Like, this is not the first time I've wanted to lose weight or be healthier or anything like that.
Yeah.
But this time what's different is I'm not focused on trying to get there as fast as possible. So I'm not willing to damage my body to get where I want to go and to be healthier. What kind of got me to this point was, you know, went on another diet about a year ago, lost a ton of weight, felt great, and then I gained it all back again, and was about ready to start doing the same program again, and really felt like God was saying, no, that's not my best for you, and that's not the way to get to where you want to go.
Right.
And I knew that I was going to have to learn just to make good choices.
Good.
So that's why I'm here.
Oh, that's so good. Okay. Can you tell me a little bit about what is your plan? What method are you going to approach as far as losing the weight? I know weight loss is a goal.
Right.
Is that your only goal, or yeah. what is this?
No, my primary goal is learning what it means to live a healthy lifestyle.
Okay.
Like, I want to figure this out to totally be free of overeating and obesity and all that stuff.
Okay.
And my main goal is to find a plan or a program or a lifestyle that allows me to do that.
Okay.
One of my milestones is to lose weight, and I want to get down to 195 pounds.
Okay.
but I have no time frame for doing that either.
Okay. Wow. 195 pounds. Can you imagine that? See, when I started, I was at 311. Started at 308 pounds, and to get down to be in the 40s, it's an exhilarating feeling knowing that I'm not losing the weight too quickly. I'm able to measure the results week over week and see those changes, gradual changes, not gigantic changes, and not just getting frustrated with myself whenever it doesn't happen. Right. So do you plan on doing any type of workout or exercise or anything like that?
Eventually. Right now, I'm just focused on figuring out how to make sure I'm eating what I need to eat every day.
Okay.
And like not letting myself be too focused on going to any extremes. Because I know that I'll burn out. Yeah. So
that's sustainability. Yeah. What I'm hearing from you is,
yeah,
sustainability. You have something that you can,
yeah,
you're not going to burn out instantly and just exhaust everything.
And I have total confidence right now that I can sustain the eating plan I'm doing forever. I could do this forever. I don't know if I could do this and going to the gym forever right now.
Right.
So I'm kind of want to get to a point where I'm like totally comfortable with this, and then I'll start adding in more exercise to make my results even better.
That's great. See, I think that exercise is the cherry on the cake, but it's 80% diet. You know, from what I hear, it's like, if it's just that little, gives you that little extra push, and just to be able to hear that you're not going to go all whole hog and go crazy at it.
I like hog, though.
Yeah.
I do like
hog. Yeah, me too. Well, God is a good God, and I know He wants to heal us. He wants to transform us. He wants us to be good witnesses. He wants us to be able to reach so many people out there that are hurting.
Right.
And I just want to encourage that to you. If you want to experience a new level of freedom and you're struggling with weight issues particularly, realize that the weight issue is just a small part of things. It is more of a spiritual thing. You have to have your heart right. You have to have your heart in order so that you can be all that God created you to be. Being overweight, being morbidly obese, like in my case, my knees hurt. I can't even squat down to tie my shoes. I have to grab a chair. I'm always having to hold things to position myself because I can't support my own weight. That is a miserable lifestyle. It's a miserable way to live.
Totally.
And even if I have just a small chance of changing any of that, of changing my family tree for future generations and setting that example before them, I want to do that.
Yeah.
And I'm glad you're on board with that too.
I am totally. I think for myself and most people that have suffered with being obese, like, it's a blanket on top of your identity.
Yeah.
Like, it's something that, it doesn't change who you are, but it changes how willing you are to be who you are, if that makes sense. And for me, like, it's really caused me, I grew up obese, so most of my life I've been protecting myself from other people and what they might think of me or how they're gonna see me.
Yeah.
And I wanna get rid of that. I don't want that to be a barrier or to cause me to be afraid to be me, you know?
Absolutely.
And it has, I've been afraid to be me for my entire life just because I don't want to look like a fat idiot who's, you know, overstepping his bounds and people are going to make fun of me and that kind of thing.
It's interesting the fact that you told me that you want to be that, you don't know who the real you is. Have you ever, in your previous weight loss journeys, ever discovered what glimpses of what that you
I have.
Can be?
I totally did the last time around, and I lost about 80 pounds, 85 pounds, and I started to find myself being uninhibited. Like, I was no longer afraid to interact with people, and I could stand toe-to-toe with anybody and not feel, like, inferior to them or feel like they were judging me.
Yeah.
Like, and I found a part of my personality that I didn't know was there, and I found that as I gained the weight back, I felt the need to hide more. I was less confident. I was less willing to be me. And I want that gone. Like, I'm better at being myself still, even though I have the weight, but I'm not as good as I was when I felt small, you know, I felt smaller. So it's definitely an issue all the time.
Well, we definitely are gonna wish you the best. Same here for me, you know, I keep encouraging me, I'll keep encouraging you.
Yeah.
Hopefully YouTube will also encourage Evan and
please
speak into his channel. Give him some thumbs up, give him some likes, subscribe to his channel, and just leave some comments. If you have suggestions, if you have tips, we want to hear about that. I want to hear about that. Please leave those in the comments and descriptions below as well. Thanks for watching an episode of Faith, Fitness, and Tech. I want to thank you, Evan, for joining me.
Absolutely.
And just have a great day. God bless you in Jesus' name.